Hey guys, this is David Kwan here, and I just want to talk about eBay, which I think, at times, is a crazy shopping universe in itself. It's a whole separate thing, I think. And the way people use it, it kind of baffles me, you know? I don't get why do people early bid. That doesn't make any sense. It's not like, if you really want the item, I mean, if you do early bid, you're probably not going to get the item for the price that you bid a day before the auction ends. You're just raising the price for everyone. And I think eBay, if you want to get the item that you want, you can't be lazy, because that's being lazy. That's just being like, okay, I see an item that's going to end in 2 hours. Don't really want to bother coming back here and revisiting this and bidding again. So you know what? I'm just going to put down, this is my maximum bid. My maximum bid for this is $20. Well, guess what? An hour later, somebody's going to bid, and then your computer is going to outbid that person until it reaches $20, and then somebody else is going to outbid your $20. It's going to happen. Early bidding doesn't work. So that's what baffles me. Like, if you want an item on eBay for cheap, because that's the point of eBay, right? Well, for most people, I'm assuming. I mean, the other reason for eBay is to get that rare item that you can't get anywhere else, because eBay has everything that people's ever used. You know, and they're just selling it for whatever reason. It's an interesting thing. The psychology of people who sell rare items, I wonder about that. Like, I want to get into the mind of that person. You hoarded all these items, or you collected all these like crazy items, and you're now selling them. Like, what made you decide now is the time that you want to sell? Like, I think I recently, you know, Kotaku had this article like, the guy who has the largest video game collection ever is all up on eBay. Like, a person is trying to sell that. But imagine though, for years and years, this person collected. It's like all, like from childhood on to now, like freaking just tens of thousands of video games. And now that collection he's selling. Like, why now? Does he have a financial situation, or he just outgrew them? He's moving. Well, more likely explanation, I don't know, he found a wife and his wife thinks it's childish to have like that's a crazy video game collection. I don't know, like, it's always an interesting story. I think there's always an interesting story behind why that item that is so rare is now available on eBay, you know? But that's one reason that people go on eBay, and those are usually, I think that's a minority, because those items can be just ridiculously expensive, like the golden cartridge of Legend of Zelda, like, or something like that. You're probably gonna have to pay, you know, tens of thousands of dollars for that. And most people on eBay don't have the interest or the money, mostly the money, to buy that for that price. Like, that's a collector's item, you know. And collectors are kind of a fringe group, and not to say in a negative way. You know, I think there's something uniquely kind of, in some ways, inspiring about collectors, you know, and people who have that such passion, such interest in some item, like baseball cards, or people collect the interesting things, you know. Maybe one person's treasure is not necessarily, you know, that other person's treasure, and vice versa. So eBay is a really interesting world. But I think majority of people go on eBay just because they want something cheaper than what you would get out of a normal store. And that's really why I go to eBay. And most of the things I buy on eBay, I'm kind of ashamed, but not ashamed to admit, you know, video games. It's mostly what I go on eBay for. Although, you know, some things are more practical. iPhone earphones. Like, seriously, those things get worn down so quickly. I don't understand. And it's always gets worn down the same exact way. You know, it's like I'm using it, you know, maybe it's because I wear it all the time, but even so, they should be more durable than what they are. You know, I hope they update the design of this thing, because it gets worn down so quickly. The left or the right part is always the one part that gets just muted. So you only hear stuff from one earphone out of the two. It always happens that way, until eventually the wires down here that connects to the jack, it gets, you know, ripped or something. So weird. Those things are so expensive. If you want to buy them new at like the Apple store or at a store, you'd have to pay $20 or $30 for that. On eBay, shoot, each of them is like worth a dollar. Like, buy it not price is a dollar. So I'm willing to pay some shipping price if that's all it takes, you know. $2 or $3, I'd rather pay that for earphones and get like 10 of them for the price of one. I think that's the beauty and the magic of eBay, that I can do that. But, you know, that's Buy It Now. I think Buy It Now was a, for me, when eBay added that, I was like surprised, because eBay really was for me like this universe, online universe where I like auction stuff. And the auctioning itself is kind of a thrilling thing. There's kind of a gamification in that. There's something like that itself is a process. You know, you're engaging in purchasing something that you might not actually get unless you win the bidding war. And it really feels like a war if you eBay, like, what I feel like is the proper way to eBay. To me, the proper way to eBay is to not bid until the very last minute. That's when it gets intense. So, it was harder for me now, but I have a tablet, so that makes it easier. But before the tablet, it was a lot harder for me. So I would click on the watch it on the eBay website, and I would, you know, have my phone or some kind of alarm clock device. I would see, like, oh, that's when the auction ends. So I would set the alarm to be, like, 2 minutes before that auction ends, or a minute before it ends. So I would have to do that. Now, it's easier with the tablet, or my iPhone, actually. I can set notifications. So when an item that I'm watching is about to end, the tablet, my iPad, or my iPhone, like, pops up, like, this item is about to end soon, you better get to it. So that's nice, that I don't really have to do anything, you know. Tablets makes things so much easier at times. So it's 5 minutes in, then I go in. I still don't bid. I'm actually, you know, it's a time-consuming thing, but that's what you gotta do to buy something cheap. You know, you wanna save money, there's gonna be some kind of effort involved in saving money. And that's, time is money, but that's what you do. That's what I do. I wait until it's like, for an important item, like if it's high in demand, I'll wait until it's like 20 seconds left or 30 seconds left. If I'm pretty sure that it's not as high in demand, I'll dive in when about a minute is left, and that's when it gets so intense. That's what happened this week, actually. I noticed that a Wii U was up. You know, I was just browsing through eBay for whatever reason. I don't know why I do this. I really do not know why sometimes I just have the urge to, like, oh, I just want to see what's on eBay. And I was browsing. I was like, oh, there's this Wii U. It's like $180 right now, and the auction's gonna end tomorrow. Let's see what happens with this. So I clicked watch it now. Tomorrow comes, and the eBay, like, my iPad's like, this item is ending soon. It's like, click on it, or you know, get to it. 5 minutes left. The price is at like $200. I'm like, whoa, this is amazing. Okay, so I'm actually still watching this, and it counts down to a minute left, and it goes up to $205. So somebody's definitely got there at the last minute. So I'm like, oh crap. So what happens now? I wait till 30 seconds, and it's up at $208. So I start putting it up there. I put my maximum bid at $210. I was like, do I even need a Wii U? It's just like, it's because it's so cheap that like my mindset is at this point, like, I get in there. I have a compulsive desire to get in this bidding war. $210. It goes up to $10.50. I'm like, okay, so this guy is really kind of incrementally going up. So I put $211. It goes up to $11.50. I was like, all right, this is probably gonna not end well. I just put $212, and then it counts down, and all of a sudden, you are the highest bidder. You win. I was like, holy crap! I just won the bidding war that I didn't really know, like, why, like, I wanted a Wii U so bad, other than after the fact, like, oh, I just got a Wii U now. I mean, granted, eBay now is a system where the buyer who bids for the war, who ends up winning, doesn't have the obligation to pay for it, you know, but, like, I still, like, for that price, $212 for a Wii U is still a good, really bargain price, you know, and I think that's a good price, and the shipping was free, incredibly enough. So, yeah, I have a Wii U now. But that's how you do, I think, eBay auction. You wait until the last minute. You gotta be watching it. Or some kind of have an alarm or notification somewhat set up. Because the last 30 seconds of an eBay bidding war is intense. Like, there's no guarantee whatsoever that you'll win, even if you, you know, are sticking it to the end at the last minute. But if you're early bidding, for whatever reason, I don't know why you're early bidding. You're just ruining it for everyone else if you're early bidding. And that's why, like, it really doesn't make any sense. As a seller, it's also interesting. Because I sold a couple items on bidding on eBay before. And I think on any store, you know, on any other online store or something, you put an item up there, and then you see, like, you know, nobody's actually clicking on buying it or whatever. That's discouraging. On eBay, no one bids for it. You can still actually have a counter on how many people are watching the item. So that's actually, that's the encouraging part. There's one item that I sold before. It was a video game. And I started the bidding price at, like, super low, at, like, $5. And it's actually, you know, at the time, like, a $50 game or something. This is when I used to sell games. I don't ever sell my games anymore. Just because I feel like, when I buy them, there's no point to sell them because I like to have this collection. I guess that's my collection. That's what I collect, I guess, video games, for whatever reason. But yeah, I would see that it had a lot of watchers, you know, hardly anyone was bidding. Some people were stupid to do early bid. You know, it went up to like $10 and 3 days was left until the auction ended. And then by the time a day is left, it went up to $20. Again, people are early bidding for whatever reason. Stupid, but there are a lot of people watching this item. So I wait, and then, you know, after a day, like, it remains at $20 for, like, the longest time. 5 minutes is left, and it starts going up like crazy. 30 seconds is left, it goes from, like, $30 to, like, $55. I thought that was amazing, and that can happen on eBay. The last 30 seconds of an auction on eBay, it gets ridiculously intense. And I have to, like, the people who are in that moment of last 30 seconds of that bidding ending, it's furious. Like, it's a furious kind of rapid decision making. Like, do I really type in, like, a lot more than I should? Like, or do I go, like, super incrementally? If I go super incrementally, then the other person might outbid me because they're actually bidding their maximum bid. Like, where do I go with this? I think I really lucked out with this recent Wii U bidding because I went really incrementally too. If the other person was just like, you know, screw it, I'm going to do my maximum bidding at $230. There's no way I could have won because the time it required me to figure it out that the person's maximum bid was $230, like, I would not have made it. But even then, like, even if that was the case, then I probably would not have wanted to bid at more than, you know, $220. That probably was my personal maximum bid for a Wii U, because especially considering I didn't really want a Wii U at all this time. I got to... of, like, getting a Wii U because of that eBay compulsive intensity-ness, you know? It's that intensity that drove me to buy a Wii U, not necessarily because I wanted a Wii U, you know? That's the crazy thing about eBay. It's exciting. I think it's a whole, like I said, it's a unique realm of shopping. Like, nobody ever shops this way, the way you do on eBay auction. And that's just kind of the experience I wanted to share in this video. Hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.